only small ripples on the water. A surfer riding a wave may not know it, but the reason his wave curls is because the orbital motion of the water has become faster the larger the waves become. Water. The waves grow even larger. We see that the harder the wind blows, the larger the waves become. Why do they do this? The effect of a wave is to make particles of water move in circular orbits. They travel toward the coast from many different angles. But as waves get closer to the shore, they swing around until they are almost parallel to the shoreline. The deeper we go, the smaller the orbits become. Waves slow down. Water moves less and less. But on the far side, there is no measurable motion at all. All waves travel out from the area where they were created. They continue traveling until they meet an obstacle, in this case, the shore of a lake. It will not slow down until it too reaches shallow water. This distance is called the wavelength. When one part of a wave moves faster than another part, the wave bend traveled from somewhere out at sea where the wind was blowing. Great storm waves like these are found with them blowing for a long time. Now we know something about how water moves in a wave. But why do waves break as they approach the shore? Waves spread out from the storm centers where they are created and may travel for thousands of miles before they lose their energy or meet an obstacle, such as the shore. A wave breaks when it travels from deep water to shallow water. Travel along with the waves? What else happens to waves as they move into shallow water?